Okay, here I am for the first casting of the Board Game Geek second tournament. I am here with Andrew from Sweden. Hello, Andrew. Don't forget to push the talk.
Hello. Yeah, sure. Hello.
We're here to cast to record the game between Drinking and Sohum. Unfortunately, this is the third time we try to record this. Sohum has dropped two times until now. We're now trying restart of the computer and seeing if that caused any issues. Drinking is the only player I know in the past. He's one of the first players I played in Octagon with. Sohum I do not know. He's a new player for me. And we're going to see Tsinteki replicate the perfection versus Noise. The last two games ended abruptly, so we're hoping to see a full game this time. So, what do you think of Sohum's start, Andrew?
I don't really know how to call it. It's really bad when you get the same type of ice over and over again. He can't play the toll booth. He has ice walls, which are really good. But as soon as Noise gets a corroder, he'll just bash through them like there's no more. But it's a good opening hand.
It's good. And especially since Noise doesn't have a corroder, it's really going to cramp his style, because he has he'd be able to trash one with Parasite, but he has a replacement in his hand. So he's going to really stop Noise cold. And I think we're going to see Noise drawing cards continuously in the first few turns until he can get that corroder out or get another Parasite.
Yeah, definitely. That's what's going to happen, and that's what should happen. So, yeah, we'll see.
On the other hand,
maybe he gets it as the first card. You never know.
Yeah. Unfortunately, the Sohum doesn't have any economy, on the other hand. So, it's going to be a bit tricky to actually play those agendas he has in his hand. He's running on Archives?
No, I was looking at Archives.
Okay, sorry.
Yeah, there's an essay there.
Ah, he just trusted.
Yeah, it got interesting.
Yeah. Well, on the other hand, I think it's for the best, because if Sohum drew another agenda, he was probably not going to do anything with it. But
still, you don't want it there. It is true. He doesn't want the agenda in his hand, but in the archives, it's a bit worse.
Hmm. Now he's going to parasite one of them.
Yeah, definitely.
And then Sohum is just going to troll him with trashing in the play in another one. Oh, he's actually not playing the Parasite immediately.
He might want to Parasite, Data Sucker, and then go on Archives. See more cards.
Mm-hmm. Probably.
Or he just decided that he really needs that Corroder.
Probably what will happen, what I suspect will happen, is that he's going to play Data Sucker, run Archives, play Parasite, trash the Wall of Ice, and run R&D in one turn.
Yeah, that's what I think he's going to do too.
So if I was him, I would immediately ice Archives a bit better. That the Wall of Thorns is not a bad idea. Just put it there, leave it until you can raise it.
Ice Wall's, again, not a bad idea.
Second Ice Wall on R&D, you mean?
No, sorry, on Archives. And that's what he's going to do?
No. He wants to play that agenda. He knows he cannot get Breakthrough, so he's probably going to go for a fast agenda.
Yeah.
I wonder which
he
one.
He can do it with that Brain Trust, so it's doable.
Mm-hmm. He's going to go for a 3 with Brain Trust immediately? No. It's not going to be a good idea. His economy is really in the sitter. So I suspect he's going to just go into Brain Trust next turn, but it's going to hurt.
Yeah, usually when you do this, you want to see how the runner plays it. If he doesn't see a corroder that early on and he sees a few credits, I'd leave it on for longer. Mm-hmm. I actually think he's thinking of doing that too, because that's why he drew the extra credit anyway.
On the other hand, as a corp, you really want to score your agendas as fast as possible in the tournament, because you never know what's going to hit you. There you go. Archives, and then almost certainly a parasite somewhere.
Yeah, we're gonna see a parasite. I think on R&D maybe.
Let's see. It's not a good idea to play the parasite now because he can just wipe all counters. No, actually, it won't make a difference if he wipes all counters now.
Yeah, definitely.
But
Yeah, it doesn't matter. It just resets.
actually, if I was in Teki, I would wipe all counters at the moment because it would wipe two imp and one data sucker. So that's not bad at all.
Yeah, he might actually do it. We'll see. Yeah, but still a very good plugin. We forgot to congratulate you for that on the previous videos, but really good plugin, works really well.
No worries. Oh my God, he just keeps drawing those agendas, doesn't he?
Why not just draw them all?
He just drew another Nisei.
Yeah, I know, I know. Well, Nisei after Nisei is not the worst thing,
No,
as
it's
long as he
not.
can't go in.
But then again, you don't have any economy, do you? I'm wondering why he didn't play any ice there. He didn't play.
He played
He advanced it
well.
once.
Yeah, why would that's bad move.
That's just so bad move. He just.
That's it.
That
It'll
make.
go away just as fast. He did absolutely nothing except waste a click and a credit.
Exactly, absolutely. It did nothing. He's just going to trash it now with the data socket that he already has and didn't save him any time. If he
Yeah.
play if he had played that ice wall, the wall of thorns, he would have had an extra credit now.
Just so bad.
Yeah.
Very bad move.
I mean, sometimes you may do that if you just don't want to spend so many credits or something, you want to play it slow, and you but with had that second in the game, well, there's no point in that.
And in that position, it was just everything about it
Oh,
was a bad
ouch,
move. Yeah.
ouch, oh no.
Yeah, no, it's at least this one's gonna end soon. As long as he runs against it, it's gonna
But
end.
have you noticed how many agendas have been? There have been four
Yeah,
agendas.
have you noticed what just happened? Because we're gonna see a very nice we're gonna see another parasite.
Yep.
That's what's gonna happen. And yeah, it's gonna end soon.
He's not going to end soon if he runs that agenda there because what did he do? Oh, okay. So I think Drinky didn't want to run on the remote server and he misclicked.
Yeah, what I happened to me once too, but and I should just he should just leave it like that.
I would say that to be fair, he also. Sohum was a bit too rushed to raise his ice. I usually let the runner target the ice they are approaching, and then I raise it just to make sure.
Yeah, that is true. But
That's.
if I was him, I wouldn't mind all that much seeing that ice wall over there. The problem is he probably wants to use that imp on R&D. That's what's happening.
Yeah, but it's not a
Yeah,
bit.
but see, he's a nice guy. He just let it go.
And it's not a bad move anyway. I mean, it's a logical move to make anyway.
Yeah, that is true. Why didn't he? Oh, yeah, he probably wants to do the double run when he trashes and then accesses again. So he wants a lot of accesses on R&D. Now he sees. Yeah, he got an enigma.
He's probably going to put it in his R&D. Let's see.
He has to.
No, in my opinion, I would have put the Wall of Thorns there and made some money because you really want something powerful on your R&D.
Yeah, but you have to remember they've played before, and he knows that drinking has a forge activation orders. So he puts him on ice, he counters. He knows bad things might happen. It happened in the first game, so.
Yeah, it's true, it's true. Which is why that advancing on the Wall of Ice was so bad. You could have played that Wall of
Yes.
Thorns now.
That is the one move we've seen that made absolutely no sense.
No. There we go. Force him to lose a click. And we're going to see that parasite come down now. What are they waiting for?
Yeah, it's probably figuring out where he should put it, because it's not that easy.
Yeah, he doesn't actually have the money to play it, so he was thinking he should use the modded.
Which is a good idea. My only problem is he doesn't know this, but if he would have placed it on any of the other two, he would have had a big chance of accessing some nice agenda if he runs against his hand, because he has the imp. That's really destructive, because he can take out some really expensive ice.
Yeah, yeah.
So the best move would have been on his hand, but he has no idea that that's true.
Mm.
There's another agenda in Archives, and he's going to draw it now. Yep.
Oh. I wonder why he didn't run R&D. He could have trusted that he had only one counter.
No, no, no. Yeah, he needs one more. That's what he's waiting for. And I think he's going to run on Archives. He's going to get one more agenda.
Sohum should really...
Yeah, the Wall of Static needs to go on Archives.
What kind of agenda is it?
A fetal AI.
Okay.
It's
well, actually, if he actually runs the Archives without taking money, he won't be able to score it. He needs two credits. It's going to be very annoying a bit. You're going to be like, run, oh, take a credit, run.
That is true, but he won't mind all that much, because he can get he gets the data sucker comfort.
Yeah, yeah. Absolutely.
The problem is that this was the only correct move. Yeah,
yeah.
He made it.
Yeah. I'm not sure I like his the choice of ice he's putting in his hand. He has very expensive ice in his deck. He doesn't have any cheap ice to protect his central servers. This means that Wall of Ice is a very decent ice, but in this Jinteki, you don't want to just end the run. You want to actually do something nasty to the player. So Ichi is perfect.
Yeah, Ichi just screams Jinteki, especially in this version.
Yeah.
Problem is, he knows he wants to protect those servers early on, so that you don't just leak the agenda out. So he's probably using it as... very early game ice.
Mm.
Like, his ice is pretty much split into early game and late game.
Yeah.
Or, like, mid-late game. He has, like, really expensive, powerful ice, like Tollbooth or Wall of Thorns.
Yeah.
And then he has this really cheap one that he can res early on. Yeah. I don't know. Like you said.
In my case, for example, I have Wall of Thorns, which is very decent. But for mid-game, for early game or mid-game, I always use Itzis and Neural Katanas. They will hurt you if you run. So you really want to, and because you really want to be able to protect all three remote servers before you start raising your remote use. So you want cheap ice that's harmful. And Neural Katana and Ichi is the best ones you have for this purpose.
Yeah, that is true. You want to protect all three central servers if you're... if you're running this identity engine, thank you, replicating perfection.
Yeah.
Because it's really good. They just have to go through the first one, and you know that. If they have a ice wall, it's going to cost one if you have a corroder. Not much.
Even Victor is better than the ice wall in this case, I think. Because Victor will at least make him waste two clicks on the first round.
That is true, but I will never admit that Victor is a decent piece of ice.
No, if he... Honestly, Victor should have had one influence. I don't understand why he had two influence.
Yeah, it's such a... I've won entire games on Victor alone.
Mm.
On the Corp having to play a Victor. Like, entire games. It's very bad.
Victor, you have to play with others. We have to play with other... Bioroids. It's just a Bioroid to make your other Bioroids better.
Yeah, he's there to spend the clicks.
Yeah, exactly. But the problem is that Victor has only three strengths, so Yogg just breaks through him. It's just... no. There we go. We're going to see FAO. There we go. And he put his expensive ice, did he?
I don't remember that was. Oh, yeah.
He put his tool booth. Oh, no.
Yeah, it's going to go away.
Well,
It's the second time that Sohum has lost toll booth to for the activation orders. It happened
And
once in the first game too.
he's only end up having to protect everything with barriers, which is like, oh, let me just find that corroder and I won.
Yeah, exactly. And he's like, what Sohum has in his hand, again, drinkink doesn't know. He has two World of Thorns. So that corroder just wins him the game.
Yeah, and also drinking was playing it smart. He first ran the archives to make sure that he wanted to keep him out. Because Sohum was suspecting he had an FAO and he still read the archives. So now drinking knows that archives are important.
Yeah, definitely. As soon as he gets like two more points, I'm pretty sure he'll just run it.
He needs the corroder first, but yeah. Now, if I was drinking, I would be. Sorry, if I was Sohum, I would just play that Wall of Thorns on the R&D and then try to score the agendas as soon as fucking possible. This is this no, it's not winnable at this moment.
Yeah, but now he got a neural katana. That got interesting.
I got into it, true.
That's definitely a better choice to put on R&D right now.
I'm not so
He can
sure.
res the katana.
True, you are true. You should play the katana R&D and then advance once and take a credit.
Yeah, that's exactly what he needs. Ah, he
No,
took two credits.
no, no. If he advanced once now, he would be able to score the agenda, play another agenda immediately.
Yeah, definitely. That was a. I think too, that's what I would have done too in that position.
But maybe he
Yeah,
doesn't. He
it's been there for too long. He has too many agenda in his hand. He has an agenda in his archives, and the corroder is going to pop up at some time. So it's
Oh, look at this. He's running R&D. Let's see if he must hit that wild side. That's going to be big.
yeah, that wild side's gonna be make or break.
Crap, crap, crap.
No.
No!
Yeah,
He's just not
he got
lucky.
very lucky. Yeah.
He left the infiltration on the wild side. Come on.
Yeah.
The guy just doesn't have any luck.
Yeah. It would be funny if he would win the game also, like just now.
I don't think he has priority requisitioning, to tell you that I haven't seen one, so I doubt he has any 3-pointers.
Yeah, he might not.
He has 3 Nisei, 3 AI, 3 Brain Trust, and did you see what the other might be?
No, I don't think I've seen any on the rise so far. Yeah,
Interesting.
but it's yeah. Now it's gonna get interesting. We see the money, and drinking is penniless because he's going to play that wild side.
True, true. So let's see. I would probably play that Wall of Thorns on R&D, or maybe Archives. Archives is
Archives does not win him the game, so.
True.
He needs to be paranoid, but maybe not that paranoid. Oh, and he got the ace ups. Oh, nice.
Yeah, but he doesn't have. He can get away with that imp. But now is the time for Sohum to be scoring agendas aggressively.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Now is the moment to do it. And he should. That Nisei should. Three
He should really
counters on it.
play the Wall of Thorns of top of his Wall of Ice and then play the agendas aggressively. You need to score as fast as possible.
Yeah, definitely. The only problem is if he puts the Wall of Thorns there, that's going to cost him basically all of his credits if he also rests.
That's very nice. Wall of Thorns, Melange, set.
Yep, that's going to do just fine.
Yeah. Wall of Thorns, Melange. If he's lucky and he doesn't get a corroder soon, he's going to actually get a very nice time.
Yeah.
Let's see. Let's see if he can manage to hold this game.
Yeah, it got interesting.
It's That's what I don't like to do. I've learned it the hard way. If you play all your ice, then noise is just going to parasite the ice where you're open, and then just run there. You keep your pussy talk open so I can hear myself.
Yeah, sorry.
So,
Sorry, I turned it off now. Yeah.
yeah. So you really want to keep an ice in your hand in case noise gets through and trashes one of your eyes. You need to be able to plug that hole immediately.
Yeah, definitely. I'm thinking now, yeah, he has a parasite and a forge activation order. That's gonna make it interesting soon.
Did he? He just drew them. Oh,
Yeah, we will say.
Let's see. Let's see.
He also has a data sucker that has four counters on it, so he
See,
can really trash something. Oh yeah,
he wants to
he's
get
going
into
for the
archives.
FS.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, he knew before that he wants to get into archives. So, but it's not going to win him the game. So it's interesting. It's interesting because he won't be able to get into R&D and headquarters anytime soon. So, Chinteki does have a chance. A bit of a lance here, raise those wall of thorns, and he's pretty safe from R&D.
Yeah, it
Question.
depends if he's gonna. Yeah. Yeah. He could forge activation orders and then he really sabotages.
No, no
There
money.
it goes.
No money. That's nasty. Now he can play another ice just to piss him off.
If he draws it.
Yeah. But as I said, you need to plug the holes.
Hey, he might just stim hack into it.
He doesn't have an icebreaker.
He doesn't need. No, he can stim hack now because he has.
Ah, that's. You won't give him the game. That's not worth it.
Yeah, no, definitely no, but it's an option.
Yeah, it is.
It would be definitely the funniest stim hack use ever.
But it would be fun if he got in with one turn to win, for example, and he got like three two vital AIs that he couldn't score, and the other guy like, oh, I score my edge and I win. Now he should score a res. Yeah, excellent.
Yeah, the problem is because he res now, he can't res the Milan.
Oh yes. Oh, nasty.
That's why that wasn't such a good idea.
Probably not, but then again, he shouldn't have played that ice. Told you, man. So that was just not a good idea.
Yeah, no, he needed to res it if he put it there, but he did not need to put it there. He
Exactly.
had too few cards in his hand. He was not going to draw more cards on his turn if he has wild side.
Exactly.
Just four cards was not enough. Yeah, it was good enough.
So now he's going to take 3 bits, probably. Drawing? What is he doing? Okay.
Yeah, he was hoping what he was doing. He was hoping for some ice for the archives.
Probably. But he doesn't have any money, so it doesn't make any sense.
The fourth ice wall.
The data mine.
The people even played that. I mean, you do the statistics. You should do the statistics on what cards they
I
played.
don't.
They hardly even played anymore.
I can't record those statistics. I can't record the deck cards. But I do play it in some decks. I've actually
I
won
mean, I
games
would
with
say
data mine.
it's not the worst icebreaker. Sorry, because that's reserved for Victor. But it's not up there.
I think the cell portal is even worse than Victor.
That is true. But I think Sunset, we have this card called Sunset that's rumored to rearrange the ice in the
That's
server.
going to make cell portal marginally better, but
Yeah.
not.
Yeah, I think it'll actually make it playable. You can actually, yeah, sometimes you actually want it in your super server.
There you go.
I'm not saying people are going to play seven of them, but or three, but you're gonna have one or two. It really screws with the runner.
Yeah, time for that melange. Just as he got the pad campaign, that's annoying. He forgot he doesn't get damage from Vitaliae. Oh, do you? No, you don't.
No, it says that if you're there, you don't.
Yeah.
It's an archives, it doesn't trigger. Just R&D and
Yeah. I'm just wondering
or install.
if it triggered now and I didn't notice it. No, I don't think it triggered.
No, it didn't. It didn't.
Ooh, he's not like with his icebreakers at least, so it's giving a chance
No.
to our friend to be able to sustain himself for a bit. I'm guessing he's going to eat the wall of thorns in the face now. He's going to run that remote and eat that wall of thorns.
He doesn't have any money, not really worth it right now.
True. He's going to get a credit and run it though. Say, okay, it's worth it to see what it is. You could have played that infiltration, but oh, what am I
That's what I'm
saying?
thinking. He might play the infiltration there.
No, he's trying to be able to play his console, I think. Come on,
I'm
Melan.
not sure the console does that much for him right now, really. I don't think he needs it. He won't like super boost his viruses anymore. That data sucker's enough for him. I think he's just saving it in case he gets that corroder.
Okay. So
Or it's good to build up a bank. He's not getting anything that gives him any actual money, so he's just building a bank right now.
it's interesting what he's going to do now. He's going to try and score an agenda. In his position, I would probably take another Melange, but it's scary. If he manages to play a Corroder now, he can get in. He's going for the pad. I don't like this at all. He using Melange one more time would have been better.
Definitely. He didn't need that ban campaign right now.
No.
Yeah.
What is he going to do? Is he going to advance twice? No, he can't afford it. He needs to be able to raise that wall. Oh, come on. Just to play the pad campaign. That was just a waste of money.
Yeah, he could have probably did without done without that, so.
Absolutely. Melange would have given him more money than he's going to make this game anyway. This game is going to
And
end.
again, no corroder.
The poor guy must be pulling his hair out. Where's my fucking corroder? I'm suspect he's going to FAO that last dice.
Yeah, first he's gonna do this. Let's see what he trashed.
He wants to just win the game quickly.
Yeah, it didn't help him though.
No. But that data sucker is getting bigger, so he'll be able to
Yeah, that is true.
trust that the Wall of Thorns as soon as he gets a parasite or a.
Yeah, but we might see a cleanse virus counters.
Downed it. At this moment, the other Sohum wants to play that Melange, get the money, and then just start advancing agendas aggressively.
That is true.
I
Yeah, we're gonna
honestly,
see.
I don't agree at all with the way he plays it. Especially that pad campaign was absolutely worthless.
Yeah, and it's gonna go away too.
Yeah. This time he did it correctly. Let's see if he's going to eat a face full of Wall of Thorns. No, he's playing it safe. I wonder why he's afraid
Yeah,
of that.
he's done. Yeah.
Come on. Are you going to Melange eventually? He has so many cards he can waste. I mean, he could have Melange two times now. Oh, more agendas. Come on. Melange, start playing those agendas.
Yeah. The problem is it's really scary. What do you play it behind? You
You
play it
did
behind the Wall of
you
Thorns?
no no no
You
no no
know he's gonna get the corroder. You know that the corroder
Yeah,
is
but
going to be the full install.
that's why he needs to score the agendas before he gets a corroder. He needs to score that brain task, play, get the money with the Melange, and then keep playing the agendas and trying to score them immediately. So
Yeah, but I think he's just scared of he's gonna get a corroder now.
and so what? He can score the brain trust. If the he can with
That is true.
the Corroder, he will go and get his R&D as well, where he's keeping three agendas. So what's the point?
Yeah, his HQ, yeah,
Yeah.
it's open.
I would have scored, I would have trust. Oh, come on. You trust the Trick of Light, man, not the others. We're never going to play the Trick of Light now. No Corroder. Oh, he's so saved.
It's never gonna happen.
Let's see. What he needs to do now is steal Brain Trust. Then next agenda score, next agenda score. Just get those points while you can. I wonder if he runs snares in his deck.
Do you have any Jinteki decks that don't run snares?
No. There's no reason not to. At least one.
Oh, that's my point.
I haven't seen a snare. Oh, I have seen a snare in the first game, and he couldn't pay for it.
Yeah.
So, is
No,
he going?
he likes drawing agendas. He doesn't go for snares.
So I'm guessing he's going to go for the gin and get his parasite out.
Yeah, that's what he needs to do.
But if Sohum is a bit lucky, he's going to get another ice and put it in front of his agenda server.
Yeah, he needs to do that. If he manages to pull off an ice, that's great.
Question is, what ice?
Let's see archives. Let's see what's gone until now. Yeah, so we have two toll booths, an ice wall, an enigma, a wall of static, and a wall of thorns.
All the ice.
A lot of ice. That's seven pieces of ice, yes. For a neural katana.
He's just trying to mill his R&D and get the agenda that way.
Well, why wouldn't he?
True. He should put something on his archives just to make sure he won't win. What did he get?
An enigma and a melange.
Oh, the Melange is the one he draws from his hand.
Yeah.
So he's really drinking. He just wants to get that agenda and win. But he's Sohum, if he's smart, he needs to make him pay for it. He needs to put an ice. There we go. Put that matrix analyzer there. Advance your agenda twice. But at least put that matrix analyzer there.
Yeah, if he's not going to do that, what's his plan? He has three agenda in his hand, no real icebreakers as soon as he gets a corroder. He needs to start advancing them before that corroder comes in.
No, come on. Let's see if he's going to advance anything now. Finally. But that's a bad idea. I don't know, maybe he's trying to scare the runner so that he's going to advance the card behind it and make the runner think it's a June bug. But at that point, the runner is going to probably have seven cards in his hand, is going to eat it and say, okay, I don't care.
Yeah, I don't think. Yeah, he's not running anymore. He just trashes one of his data suckers and he got another one. He's just gonna go through his viruses until he gets them.
Let's see if he's going to win the game in one click. He's going to play the data sucker, run again, see, hope he wins. Which is going to be annoying because he won't be even able to score 2 points. So whom? But this game can go either way, depending how fast, how lucky noise is with the milling and how fast he can get a corroder.
Yeah, what do you do with that brain thrust? Do you just score it without any extra tokens
Usually,
on
it's not worth it. You need to raise four ice in order for a one counter brain task to make his cost back.
Yeah, and that's what I'm thinking right now. That's definitely what he should do right now. He's been through a lot of ice. Just score it as fast as he can, put the miss save in, and that's it.
I do hope our friend won't drop again.
Yeah, there's a snare. We found one. It's in archives.
Drinking must be really desperate at the moment. Come on, one agenda.
Yeah, I think he should play the deja vu right now. Take the data sucker and whatever
He
virus
doesn't
he
have
has.
the he does have the money for it. He scores addresses the data sucker.
Yeah, I think he'll do it next turn. That's what he's gonna do.
Sohum needs to protect his archives. Finally, put something in the archives, but score those agendas as well.
Yeah,
But
it's hard to protect archives when you don't draw any ice.
yeah. Play now he needs to score brain task, play Nisei, advance Nisei once. Try to score those agendas, man.
That's definitely what he should do. Brain trust Nisei, advance them once. If he gets one Nisei in, that's really good.
It's okay. He won't be able to protect his archives, but he may be able to save his Melange, for example, or his agenda for one turn.
Yeah, his agenda for one turn is what I'm thinking. He's gonna draw some other ice at some point, so yeah.
I get the suspicion he's just going to play some random Zaibatsu. Ah, okay, there we go.
No, I mean, yeah.
But it all depends on the corroder. Will he get that corroder in?
Oh
What?
boy, not this again.
What?
Yeah,
No!
he wants to use the trick of light. That's what's gonna happen.
Okay.
He's gonna use the trick of light with the Nisei and score it without it being down for very long.
True,
But that
true.
just says you have agenda in your hand.
True.
If you give the corroder, then he should just run his hand like there's no.
No, is he going to not draw cards? What is he hell is doing?
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. No, he should draw first. Now without that corroder. Why did he? No,
Okay.
he's just going for the viruses.
Yeah,
Yeah,
he's
that's
going
it.
to get the money, get the viruses, run.
Yeah, he's not gonna run it. That's why he did it, because he's gonna deja vu put two
No,
viruses
no,
here.
no. You know what he's going to do? He's going to deja vu parasites. And he's going to trash the two ice in R&D. Or maybe one ice and play the other with a mimic. And then he's going to put an imp. And start going through the archives. Sorry, the R&D. Directly.
Yeah.
So we're going
Yeah,
to see parasites in
that
the
makes
game again.
sense. Yeah. It's not fun without him.
But the good thing is Sohum has drawn so many agendas that there may be a chance that he'll survive for a bit. There we go. Here come the parasites. Yeah, he can play one and probably an imp. What's he gonna play? Parasite, parasite. So that's interesting. What he's going to play it. One is going to go to the Wall of Thorns in R&D. I wouldn't play it on the katana. I mean, the katana you can break with your mimic.
Yeah, we'll see.
He's probably going to play the other one on the Wall of Ice. Let's see. If he was smart, he would play it on the Wall of Ice on the headquarters and run headquarters.
Yeah, no, if he's gonna
Ah,
use
there you
the
go.
other
There
one,
we go.
there was no point in playing it on the advanced one.
Ah, that's going to hurt.
Yeah. Let's see if he runs and what he runs.
Let's see. I think he's going to run its headquarters
He should run
because.
HQ. Right now, he should definitely run HQ.
No! Okay, Sohum needs to wipe counters immediately. Although that won't save his ice wall. Oh man, it's
Yeah, it
difficult.
doesn't help. Yeah, but he did get a toll booth right now.
Okay, so trash ice wall, play toll booth.
Yeah, definitely.
Play
Yeah, he
Nisei.
needs to do that in front of
Play Nisei. And.
advance at once.
Yeah, maybe advance it once, yeah. He needs to immediately go on the fast advance. There's no way. And then depending on if the guy runs his toll booth, he can res his he can use his melange once more to get the money.
Yeah, the funny thing is, if he runs toll booth like without taking any credits, he'll just end the run.
Exactly. Come on, don't drop. Don't drop.
No, he's still in.
Headquarters, trust that ice. There we go.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, saved. Saved by one click. Play that Nisei.
And now, because I don't know why he trashed that wild side, really.
I think he was hoping that he would be able to win the game in one turn.
Yeah, but there's only two agenda points in the court. Why risk it? You don't risk it when you're in a good position. Just wait until you get that corroder and Shazam, you're done.
Yeah, he should have run HQ. He had a golden opportunity.
Yeah, that
Honestly,
was definitely.
if I was his place, I would have gotten a parasite and an imp, played the imp, played the parasite on HQ, run HQ two times. Or one time and then trash a card if I don't hit an agenda.
It's gonna be hard now.
He's trashing his parasite, his data cycle with the tokens, okay.
There is another thing. If he puts he doesn't have the money. He will need to put a yogi in, and he can go get past that toll booth if he can pay it
Yeah, but he
the
doesn't know it's
best.
a toll booth.
Yeah. He just put himself in a bad position,
On
but
the other hand, he does have the Steam hack. He can get in if he really wants to.
is he gonna install a bag?
Don't think so. He's playing far too safe, far too safe. What's he afraid of? Run this goddamn archives, man. Play the mimic and run the archives. There we go.
You mean R&D?
R&D, sorry.
Yeah, he has the money. Yeah, there you go.
Let's see if he goes to win the game on the fast.
He doesn't have any more imps now, so.
If he hits a fatal AI, it was going to be very funny. Okay. So he doesn't even have the money to pay for his mimic now, so that's interesting.
Yeah, he just had big money.
Yeah. So interesting. Let's see what Sohum is going to do.
As I bought.
Come on, score those agendas. Forget about anything else. You don't care.
Oh yeah, no, he's just like he should have only one goal. Oh, it's not
No!
that bad of a move because he can't trust both the toll booth and
Yeah,
the
but look,
box.
look. You want to take the agenda points to even if you lose now. If Noise hits his card from R&D, he gets an agenda. He lost the game. Yeah, he doesn't have the
Yeah, that is
points.
true.
So
Yeah,
it's
that is true.
better to have the safe bet for next game that you have 4 points to win.
Why is he still drawing cards?
He, maybe, I don't know. Yeah,
Maybe he wants a deja vu and he wants that imp.
maybe. They're both playing it extremely safe. I'm really surprised.
I mean, really, right now, he should just go for the R&D. Why?
That's okay, but he doesn't have the money to play it. So what's he going to
No,
do?
but that's not what he wanted.
He's probably going to play now, play the infiltration. There we go. Oh, bleh.
Not the worst move. It's gonna spend some credits.
No, he should have done this last time. He could run that
Yeah.
thing and then hit the Milans as well, and then you raise both eyes and you know what it is.
If I were him, I would really play infiltration for its credits. He drew it when he shouldn't have. Play it for the credits and then just put medium in and run for broke.
Oh, he would have won the game. If he ran R&D, he would have won the game. So saved, so close. Come on, score that
And how many agenda are left in this game apart from these ones? So we've seen,
three plus.
Nisei. We've seen three Nisei. They're all here. The Brain Trust, one in his hand, one there, and one in the score. So all Brain
Here,
Trusts, two
here.
fetal AIs. So that's eight agenda times two, 16. Four more
No!
points.
Come on, the buff is so safe!
Oh boy, they're playing this so paranoid.
Really, I mean, both of them had so many opportunities to just get some money out or get some good hits. I mean, when drinking is going to see the replay of this video, he's going to start pulling his hair when he didn't run R&D now.
Yeah, but that's how it is. Like, we see all of this, and it's a lot easier for us to say.
Yeah, obviously, yeah.
The man's probably tired by now. He's been through this game a couple of times, so it's like, yeah, it's hard. He played a really good game, and with a bit of luck, he would have just won it with one of those trashes or other stuff.
Yeah. Wow. You don't see that very often.
Yeah, I think he plans to super run on R&D
Yeah.
next turn.
Just play. I'm not sure why he didn't use his infiltration, get an extra credit out.
Yeah, he probably will do that next turn. He doesn't want to give any tips. Yeah, do you think we're going to see a melange again?
If he does another Melange, I'm going to just smack him. I mean, you need to be playing those agendas now, right
Yeah,
now.
like on the runner side, you can say he doesn't know stuff like that, but the corpse just scored that goddamn Nisei already.
Play those agendas yesterday. Don't play, forget that katana. Score those agendas.
Oh, he should just ignore that katana completely.
Yeah. I mean, it's going to cost him 2 credits to break in, which is not bad. I mean, he's going to use his medium far less, and he can afford it. He has the melange. But still, I mean, it's 4 credits for almost nothing. Not the.
What did you say?
Are you going to take those monies to the grave?
Yeah, I don't know what he's planning. Yeah, he's gonna super run R&D. How many cards are left in R&D?
11.
11. And
So,
there's gonna be two agenda.
yeah.
So he has a pretty good chance of seeing one.
No, what?
Why the hell did he just go card?
Oh man, these players have us completely outclassed, I think. Maybe he just didn't want
Why
to
did he
hit.
bother drawing the extra card?
Maybe he's afraid of hitting a snare. Don't know.
He could have hit the snare anyway.
Maybe he was afraid of hitting a snare and fetal AI. Let's see. And run again.
Yeah.
Now he Jindeki is in a bad position because next turn he's going to run R&D too many times. So if he scores the agendas, he's not going to have a chance to protect R&D. So what I'm suspecting, we'll see. No, he didn't draw a gold dice. Now, did he discard his katana? Okay.
Yeah, he did. I don't know why.
He needs to play the agendas now. Trick of light.
Yeah, trick of light and score that Nisei.
I'm suspecting he's going to draw a card and hope for a nice, but this is going to be the absolute worst choice.
He's been through a lot of his eyes.
Yeah. He needs to score agendas immediately.
And even if he draws ice, yeah, it's hard.
Ah, finally, trick of light. But he still holds them all in his hands. He didn't manage to play one because he got the money, which he didn't really need.
Yeah, I don't know why he bothered.
That was a hand buffer in case he runs his HQ. Oh well. At least he can block one of the mediums.
Yeah, but this is funny. Which one do you block?
The last
The
one.
last one. Yeah. How many runs can he do? Yeah, he can do a lot.
He can do 3 runs. He's going to trust his. Actually, he won't trust anything. He's just going to run 3 times.
Yeah, he should have trusted his djinn and he should have not installed the medium on the djinn.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, so let's see. Probably he's going to lose now. I can't imagine him winning. He's going.
Whom?
You know what's going to be very funny? If he actually runs and hits Fetal AI when he only has 1 credit.
Yeah.
That's going to be
But
funny.
if you lie. Yeah, there's still one left if he plays three of them.
Ah, he lost. He has exactly 2 credits to score it.
Yeah, perfect. Even
Yeah.
if he didn't, he could have just played the infiltration and gone again.
But he could have Nisei'd it. He could Nisei one of them.
Yeah. What would have been a long, long game.
Yeah, these guys are playing very, very, very safe.
But interesting game. We've seen some interesting moves.
Okay, so this is our first match recorded in casting. Fortunately, this time it didn't crash, and we saw an interesting game by the first round of Swiss. So, time to go for the reverse of Corp and Runner. Hopefully, we get a shorter game this time.